Well, a federal court set up a roadblock to common sense yesterday, ruling that the administration could not cut off certain federal funds to the city of Philadelphia in response to its sanctuary city policies, the ones that protect criminal aliens. In response to this news, the mayor of Philadelphia, James Kenney, broke into a celebratory dance, which we're going to torture you with right now. Watch.
A sanctuary city, yeah. A sanctuary city, yeah.
Democrats dancing at the idea of foreign citizens committing crimes in their cities. Jumaane Williams is a New York City council member, is running for lieutenant governor of New York State, and he joins us now. Mr. Williams, thanks a lot for coming on.
Thanks for having me. Always a pleasure.
So, I don't know if you've been to Philadelphia recently, and I don't want to beat up on the city. There's a lot good about Philadelphia, but Philadelphia, massive homelessness, huge crime problem, a lot of poverty in the city. And here you have the mayor more excited, not about fixing the schools or keeping his own citizens safe, but about allowing criminals from other countries, foreign citizens, to live in his city. It seems like a weird priority to me. What do you think?
Well, just to correct something, the presence of undocumented residents is not a criminal act. It's actually a civil violation. And so maybe he's excited that they won't be spending resources.
Well, no, actually, no, they're not spending any resources on it. And there are a lot of ways to look at this, but I'm speaking specifically of the Philadelphia policy that, in effect, protects criminal aliens. Aliens are all breaking the law by their presence if they're here illegally. But I mean people who commit felonies are being protected by the city of Philadelphia. Why is that in the interest of Philadelphia residents?
I know that human beings... I know you call them aliens. I'd like to rehumanize them. Human beings, whether they're citizens or non-citizens, commit crimes. The question is, why are we spending resources on one group of people? And the reason we're doing that is based primarily on fear and bigotry that's ginned up sometimes. Sometimes like folks like you, sometimes
it's
like
funny.
The president.
It's funny. Have you looked at the polling among African Americans on illegal immigration, the people you say you represent? Have you looked at the effect on their wages by the presence of millions, 20 million illegal aliens in this country? It pushes those wages down. Who are you representing exactly?
Well, actually, if you look at the data, sanctuary cities are safer, actually, than non-sanctuary
cities. It's just silly.
And they actually have better economics than non-sanctuary cities. The question
is... That's totally false. I mean, by the way, I do this for a living. I'm very familiar with the data, as you put it, and that's just simply not true. But let me ask you this question, though. At some point, does it matter to a politician whose job it is, whose sworn duty it is to represent the citizens of his district or state, whether or not someone's a citizen? These are foreign nationals. They're citizens of another country. Does that matter?
Well, in New York City, I have a lot of tourists in the city. I believe my job is to represent all the people who are in my city and in my state at any given time. And I know you're a public safety person, so my question is, why would we not view this from a public safety point of view? And as I mentioned, sanctuary cities
are safer. There's a huge... Sanctuary cities are not safer. That's one of many statistics that are fake that the left throws around, like, you know, millions of people don't have government ID, another lie from a made-up study. But let me ask you this.
That's actually a great point. We should give them driver's license. That's another thing.
No, I'm aware.
For public
You'll make it much better. Is there a difference between a U.S. citizen and a citizen of a foreign country?
Yes, you just said it. But both of them are human beings. And the question is, if we took all the law enforcement agents and said, you know what, we want you to focus on the streets that have two cars on it and that have parked wrong, those are civil violations. Why would we do that? There's no reason to do that. These are civil violations. The reason that we focus on undocumented immigrants that are probably from S-hole countries and not Norway is based in bigotry and fear. There is no public
bigotry.
Safety.
Do you think, there's a new Pew poll out that showed that far more African Americans think immigration has made their lives worse than made their lives better. Are they racist for saying that?
So the lieutenant governor of this state agrees more with you on these issues. He doesn't believe in giving driver's license.
But I'm not actually asking about the lieutenant governor of the state. I just want your view of that. Are those people racist for having that view?
And the current governor, they do policy by polls. I don't. I do policy by what's right.
No, actually, what you are doing is what many on the left do, which is go to motive. And you were saying that these concerns grow out of bigotry. You were impugning my motives. And so let me ask you about the motives as revealed in this new Pew poll. What do you think of that?
You shouldn't talk about motives when we're talking about policy. Is that what you're saying?
You're the one who brought it up. You said people support this because they're bigots. And my question was, a brand new poll just came out. It showed that far more African Americans, and of every ethnic group, I'm just picking one, are against immigration than are for it. Does that mean they're bigots too?
I don't think they're against immigration.
That it's made their lives worse.
No, it has not. And most atrocities.
They think it has.
Most atrocities in this world has been based on people who use some sort of law to separate people out and say they're the other and commit atrocities.
So you guys are so high on this ideology, you can't see straight.
When you call them from S-hole countries, that is dehumanization. When you separate
Haiti, I mean, whatever. Even to resurrect these arguments are so dumb, I can barely stand it. Let me just bring you into the present. This is the Daily News cover for tomorrow. Obviously the biggest tabloid in New York. Disgrace to our country. It's a defense of a criminal alien who's been on the lam for 8 years. But at the bottom, it says, and I don't know if you can read it, how city and state can unite against ICE.
Yes.
Do you think it's the place of Democrats to encourage open attacks on a federal law enforcement agency? Is that
like
a position
I said,
that you hold?
Some Democrats have been part of the problem. The person I run against, the lieutenant governor, why I run up lieutenant governor, agrees with you on some of these issues. And so Democrats have been part of the problem in stoking some of the fear. What I'm saying to you is we have to view these people as human beings and figure out why we're so focused on this one group of people when there is no public safety
benefit. Because their presence lowers wages for poor people. Supply and demand is a real thing. This has been shown again and again.
Pablo, who was delivering a pizza in that article you were spoken about, first of all, had he had a driver's license, he would still be here.
Okay, this is insane, actually. And if you guys ever
Time and time again, the only reason you're deported is because you've had success in ginning up fear that is
Because we're racist.
No, I didn't say that.
That's exactly what you're saying.
And
you're too cowardly to say it out loud. You're calling me a racist.
My parents are immigrants. I'm a son of immigrants, as a matter of fact.
Jumaane Williams, running for lieutenant governor of New York. God help that state. California has been a leading indicator of what the rest of the country becomes. Let's hope that's no longer true. California now has rampant poverty, failing schools, drug needles and human waste piling up on its sidewalks, bankrupt municipal governments, a vanishing middle class. At this point, California doesn't even have a shared language. Almost half the state doesn't speak English at home. Can California be saved, or is it too late? John Cox doesn't think it's too late. He's a Republican running for governor of California. He got his nomination last night. He'll be facing Gavin Newsom in November, and he joins us tonight. Mr. Cox, thank you for coming on.
Well, thank you, Tucker. Thanks for having me. You grew up in California.
I
you
did.
Lived the California dream, and now the California dream is to figure out ways to get to Texas. We got to change that. Gavin Newsom would run this state even further into the ground.
So what would you, and it's sad, even to report on it, but it matters. It's the biggest state and it's a bellwether state. There are so many problems with California. We could go on for the rest of the week on this, but if you were to narrow it down to one thing you could change about the state to keep the middle class from fleeing, to keep the state from going bankrupt, what would it be?
Well, I have to say it was the tax burden primarily. The gas tax has been really a problem here. A state senator, Josh Newman, was just recalled yesterday by 60%. They spent $8 million of special interest money to try to keep this guy in office, and the voters turned it out. And that's a good sign, Tucker, that the voters here are getting it. You know, this election is going to provide a stark contrast. Gavin Newsom talked about it. He wants to have a cradle-to-college nanny state government, as if this government isn't big enough or taxing us enough. He wants to expand that. He wants to double the income tax. He wants to increase property taxes, and he wants to make sure that we don't repeal this gas tax. I say the people of this state have been taxed enough. They're going to rebel, and we're going to lead that revolt here.
But, I mean, California owes more to its retired workers than it could ever conceivably repay. I mean, I just don't think it could ever repay that money. It's too much. And now they're proposing to give free Medicaid to illegal immigrants. So how would the state ever afford that or any of this? Like, what is the plan going forward to keep that place solvent?
Well, I'd like to think that we could grow our way out of it, but I don't even think that's available to us. We're going to have some really stark, clear conversations with a lot of these employee unions. And, we're, you know, as usual, it's the employees who are going to take the pipe on this. They're the ones that are going to get hurt. And I got to tell you, Tucker, they haven't even begun to put any money away for retiree health care. And there's all kinds of state workers that are retiring at 53, 54 years old. And they've been promised health care until they qualify for Medicare. And as we know, Medicare is going broke at the federal level. So, you know, the big problem, obviously, is that California can't print money, and its credit rating is hanging by a thread. I'm a CPA. That was my first degree. And I tell you what, I've got to level with the people of this state about the problems with this unfunded debt.
I can't imagine what it must be like to be a certified public accountant in California, to be a math guy living in a state that doesn't acknowledge the reality of math. It must drive you crazy. John Cox, thank you. Good luck. Godspeed.
All the law enforcement agents and said, you know what, we want you to focus on the streets that have two cars on it and that are have parked wrong. Those are civil violations. Why would we do that? There's no reason to do that. These are civil violations. The reason that we focus on undocumented immigrants that are probably from S-hole countries and not Norway is based in bigotry and fear. There is no public
bigotry.
Safety.
Do you think, there's a new Pew poll out that showed that far more African Americans think immigration has made their lives worse than made their lives better. Are they racist for saying that?
So the lieutenant governor of this state agrees more with you on these issues. He doesn't believe in giving driver's license.
But I'm not actually asking about the lieutenant governor of the state. I just wanted your view of that. Are those people
many,
racist for having that view?
And the current governor, they do policy by polls. I don't. I do policy by what's right.
No, actually, what you are doing is what many on the left do, which is go to motive.
Citizens or non-citizens commit crimes. The question is, why are we spending resources on one group of people? And the reason we're doing that is based primarily on fear and bigotry that's ginned up sometimes. Sometimes like folks like you, sometimes
it's
like
funny.
The president.
It's funny. Have you looked at the polling among African Americans on illegal immigration, the people you say you represent? Have you looked at the effect on their wages by the presence of millions, 20 million illegal aliens in this country? It pushes those wages down. Who are you representing exactly?
Well, actually, if you look at the data, sanctuary cities are safer, actually, than non-sanctuary cities.
It's just silly.
And they actually have better economics than non-sanctuary cities. The question
is, that's totally false. I mean, by the way, I do this for a living. I'm very familiar with the data, as you put it, and that's just simply not true. But let me ask you this question, though. At some point, does it matter to a politician whose job it is, whose sworn duty it is to represent the citizens of his district or state, whether or not someone's a citizen? These are foreign nationals. They're citizens of another country. Does that matter?
Well, in New York City, I have a lot of tourists in the city. I believe my job is to represent all the people who are in my city and in my state at any given time. And I know you're a public safety person, so my question is, why would we not view this from a public safety point of view? And as I mentioned, sanctuary cities
sanctuary cities are not safer. That's one of many statistics that are fake that the left throws around, like, you know, millions of people don't have government ID, another lie from a made-up study. But let me ask you this.
That's actually a great point. We should give them driver's license. That's another thing.
No, I'm aware.
For public
you'll
safety.
Make the, you'll make it much better. Is there a difference between a U.S. citizen and a citizen of a foreign country?
Yes, you just said it. But both of them are human beings. And the question is, if we took
poverty in the city, and here you have the mayor more excited, not about fixing the schools or keeping his own citizens safe, but about allowing criminals from other countries, foreign citizens, to live in his city. It seems like a weird priority to me. What do you think?
Well, just to correct something, the presence of undocumented residents is not a criminal act. It's actually a civil violation. And so maybe he's excited that they won't be spending resources.
Well, no, actually, no, they're not spending any resources on it. And there are a lot of ways to look at this, but I'm speaking specifically of the Philadelphia policy that, in effect, protects criminal aliens. Aliens are all breaking the law by their presence if they're here illegally. But I mean people who commit felonies are being protected by the city of Philadelphia. Why is that in the interest of Philadelphia residents.
I know that human beings, I know you call them aliens, I'd like to rehumanize them. Human beings, whether they're...
Well, a federal court set up a roadblock to common sense yesterday, ruling that the administration could not cut off certain federal funds to the city of Philadelphia in response to its sanctuary city policies, the ones that protect criminal aliens. In response to this news, the mayor of Philadelphia, James Kenney, broke into a celebratory dance, which we're going to torture you with right now. Watch.
A sanctuary city, yeah. A sanctuary city, yeah.
Democrats dancing at the idea of foreign citizens committing crimes in their cities. Jumaane Williams is a New York City council member, is running for lieutenant governor of New York State, and he joins us now. Mr. Williams, thanks a lot for coming on.
Thanks for having me. Always a pleasure.
So, I don't know if you've been to Philadelphia recently, and I don't want to beat up on the city. There's a lot good about Philadelphia, but Philadelphia, massive homelessness, huge crime problem, a lot of